Welcome back, everybody. We've been learning a lot about the ANOVA summary table because we're trying to get through all the different calculations that we need eventually to compute our F statistic. And we've spent some time looking to see how the different elements of the source table work together. Like to get mean square, we take sum of squares and divide by degrees of freedom. To get the F ratio, we take mean square between and divide by mean square within. So, in other words, the different elements of the table work together. So, if we really understand that table, we should be able to solve a puzzle that looks like this, that's partially completed, and then we get a little bit of extra information. Based on that extra information, we should be able to fill in every piece of that puzzle. So, let's read and see what we have here. It says a researcher conducts an experiment comparing four treatment conditions with a separate sample of n equals 5 in each treatment. So we know we have four groups, k equals 4. We have 5 people in each group. 4 groups times 5 people equals 20 people overall. So we know the big N equals 20. You see how already I'm getting a lot of information just by reading this little bit of information. An analysis of variance is used to evaluate the data, and the results of the ANOVA are presented in the table below. Complete all missing values in the table. All right, let me change my view for a second so I can type in some information, and then we'll start walking through it. I'll give you some tips and some strategies to get it done pretty easily. All right, now I'm able to type in a few things. So it's usually easiest to start with the simple formulas that we see, like degrees of freedom. So we learned that there are 4 different treatment groups. If there are 4 groups, remember that's K, 4 minus 1 equals 3 degrees of freedom between. So we can fill that in right here. All right, so we've got 3 degrees of freedom between groups. Sum of squares equals 12. Remember, mean square between groups is just sum of squares between groups divided by degrees of freedom between groups. In other words, 12 divided by 3, which in this case would equal 4. So let's type that in. Let's continue focusing on degrees of freedom because those are all very simple formulas. Degrees of freedom within groups says it's based on the number of people overall minus the number of groups. We determined there are 20 people overall, 4 groups, 5 people in each group. 20 people overall, which is N, minus 4 groups, which is K, would be 16 degrees of freedom within groups. Let's type that in. Well, degrees of freedom total should be 3 plus 16, which is 19. And we can look at this formula as well. It says degrees of freedom total can be computed by taking the total number of people overall, which we know is 20, and subtracting 1. So that way it equals 19 as well. So I'm feeling good. It's making sense. We were able to compute that number 2 different ways. At this point, we have to determine what else could we potentially do. There's no way we're going to compute sum of squares just based on the information we have because that information comes from our data. So somehow I must be able to find this value right in here, mean square within groups. Well, remember, mean square within groups is sum of squares within groups divided by degrees of freedom within groups, but we don't know this value of sum of squares within groups. We do know that F equals mean square between divided by mean square within. So 4 divided by something equals 2. And in your head, you can probably see that 4 divided by 2 equals 2. And in fact, we can just take this 4 and divide by 2 and find out that this would equal 2. So there are several different ways mathematically that we can reason through it. But 4 divided by 2 does equal 2. It fits. So how can we find these remaining cells? Well, think about it this way. If sum of squares divided by degrees of freedom equals mean square, then mean square times degrees of freedom should equal sum of squares. And we can see it does in this case, 4 times 3 equals 12. So we should be able to take mean square times degrees of freedom within and find sum of squares within. 2 times 16 equals 32. And at this point, in order to find sum of squares total, we can just take sum of squares between groups and add sum of squares within groups. 12 plus 32 is 44. Well, it doesn't look very pretty, but we got it done. And based on the logic that we just used in this example, go ahead and try the next example on your own. This is the last ANOVA video for this week. We'll cover ANOVA post-tests next week. So for now, take care, and I'll see you in the next video.